breath in and out. Taking our arms up overhead and leaning to the left side. Letting that bottom hand fall away and stretching out. Bringing both hands again to heart center. Hugging our breath in and out. We'll take the left hand to the right knee. Right hand travels around behind, overlooking that right shoulder. And as you exhale, slowly turning your torso and seeing if you might be able to look behind you. And coming back to center. A breath in and out. Right hand, left knee, left hand travels around behind, overlooking that left shoulder. And as you exhale, slowly turning your torso, seeing if you might be able to look behind you. And returning to center. Our breath in and out. Taking both legs wide, stretching out. Right hand to the right ankle. Taking the left arm over top. Bringing that left hand down to our right toes, right hand to our right toes, and exhaling down, nose to that right knee. And inhaling up, left hand, left ankle, and stretching the right arm over top. Bring that right hand down to our left toes, left hand to our left toes, and exhaling down, nose to that left knee, inhaling up, stretching wide, left fingers, right toes, exhaling down, nose to our right knee. Inhaling up, stretching wide, right fingers, left toes, exhaling down, nose to that left knee. Inhaling up, stretching wide, left fingers, right toes, and exhaling down, nose to our right knee again. Inhaling up, stretching wide, right fingers, left toes, and exhaling down to that left knee. And inhaling up, bringing both legs together. Here's our forward fold. Inhaling up, bending that right knee, putting that right ankle on top of the left thigh, and reaching forward for those left toes. Taking both legs long, forward fold. Inhaling up, bending that left knee, putting that left ankle on top of the right thigh, and stretching forward for our right toes. Taking both legs long, again our forward fold. And we'll do reclining tree. bringing my hands to heart center, and slowly rolling back. One vertebrae at a time until I rest back on the mat. A deep breath in and out. We'll take our arms up overhead, growing tree. Bringing our arms out to the side, springtime tree. And if you choose, we're going to pick up that left ankle and hold as we keep both arms hovering off the mat, extended out to the side for springtime tree. Bringing our hands back to heart center, relaxing that left ankle down, and then slowly rolling back up into our seated position. We're stretching our arms over those left toes. Bringing those hands down to our left toes and exhaling our nose towards that left knee. Inhaling up, taking both legs long, we'll inhale our arms up, exhale down, inhale up, exhale down, inhale up, and exhale down. Now we're going to put that left foot to the inside of the right thigh, bringing our hands to heart center and slowly rolling back one vertebrae at a time until we rest back on the mat. Taking that deep breath in and out. Stretching our arms up overhead, growing tree. Taking our arms out to the side, springtime tree. And then we're going to pick up that right ankle, let that right ankle hover off the mat, as both wrists also hover off the mat. Holding our springtime tree. Bringing our hands to heart center. And then slowly rolling up. Stretching those arms forward over those right toes. Bringing our hands down to those right toes. And we'll exhale forward, bringing our nose closer to that right knee. Inhaling up, we'll take both legs long, inhaling our arms up, exhaling down, inhaling up, exhaling down, and one more up, and down, and then coming forward into our table position. Hands and knees. Starting in our cow position with our head up and relaxing our back. Getting ready, here's cat. Inhaling, tucking my head, arching my back, pulling my tummy up, and holding. Exhaling back around into our cow. And our cat again. Inhaling, tucking my head, arching my back, pulling my tummy up, holding. And exhaling back around into our cow. And one more cat, inhaling, tucking my head, arching my back, pulling my tummy up, and holding. Exhaling back around into our cow. And then I'm going to turn to that right side, looking back at that right foot. Coming back to center and turning to the left, looking back at that left foot. Coming back to center. A breath in and out. Let's cross the right knee in front of the left. Right palm is down, rotating. Left arm and fingers overhead. Bringing that left hand down to the mat, rotating. Right arm and fingers overhead. Bringing that right hand down, we'll take the right arm underneath the left, right shoulders headed down to the mat, and taking that left arm all the way forward. If you choose, rotating that left shoulder, taking the arm and the fingers on up towards the ceiling. Placing our palms down, straightening our arms. Now we'll take this left arm underneath the right, left shoulders headed down to the mat, stretching that right arm all the way forward. Rotating the right shoulder, taking the arm and the fingers on up towards the ceiling. And then placing our palms down, straightening our arms. Exhaling down onto our forearms. And if you choose, exhaling one more time, dropping our forehead onto the mat. And stretching those arms out long in front of us. And then unwinding, coming back into our table. A breath in and out. We'll cross that left knee in front of the right. Left palm is down, rotating. Right arm and fingers overhead. Bring that right hand down, leaving the right palm down, rotating left arm and fingers overhead. Bring that left hand down. We'll take the left arm underneath the right, left shoulders headed down to the mat. Take that right arm all the way forward. If you choose, rotating the right shoulder, taking the arm and the fingers on up towards the ceiling. Placing my palms down, straightening my arms. Now I'm going to take this right arm underneath the left. Right shoulders headed down to the mat. And we'll take that left arm all the way forward. If you choose, rotating that left shoulder, taking the arm and the fingers on up towards the ceiling. And placing our palms down, straightening our arms. Exhaling down onto onto our forearms. And exhaling one more time, dropping our forehead onto the mat and stretching those arms out long in front of us. And then unwinding and coming back into our table. That breath in and out. Let's take that right arm all the way out in front and bring that left leg out behind us. Bending my left knee. Drawing that right elbow in, connecting with my left knee. Stretching out right arm, left leg. Bending that left knee. Drawing my right elbow back, connecting left knee. And stretching out. This time as you bend the left knee, we'll bring that right hand around. See if we can hang on to the left toes. And coming back into our table. A breath in and out. We'll take that left arm all the way out in front and bring that right leg out behind us. Bending my right knee. Drawing that left elbow in, connecting, right knee. Stretching out left arm, right leg. Bending my right knee. Drawing that left elbow back, connecting, right knee. And stretching out. This time as you bend your knee, we'll bring that left hand around so that we can hang on to those right toes. And coming back into our table. A breath in and out. We're going to tuck our toes, coming up, down dog. And we'll start by walking the dog. Right knee forward and back. Left knee forward and back, just like we're walking. Settling back into our down dog. We'll take the right hand over to the left ankle. Returning, down dog. Left hand over to the right ankle. Returning back, down dog. We'll put our weight on that right foot as we take that left leg out behind us for a three-legged dog. If you choose, bending the left knee, turning your hip outward, dropping that foot over your hip. And if you need it to be harder, walking your hands back, see if you can put them around the right ankle. And coming back, down dog. Putting our weight on that left foot as we take that right leg out behind us for three-legged dog. Bending my right knee, turning that hip outward, dropping that foot over my hip. If you need it to be harder, walking your hands back and see if you can put them around the left ankle. And returning back into our down dog. Walking our feet forward, right behind our hand. Slowly rolling upward, reaching on up, and settling into that mountain position. A breath in and out. Let's take the right hand down the outside of the right thigh, stretching the left over top. Coming back into our mountain. Left hand down the outside of the left thigh, stretching the right over top. And returning back into our mountain. A breath in and out. We'll take that into our sun salutation. Arms overhead. Coming forward, forward fold. Hands behind our calves, relaxing our head, relaxing our neck. Putting our hands on the mat in front of our toes, bringing those hands up to our knees, down into the mat, up to my knees, down to the mat, and once more, up to my knees, and back down to the mat. We'll lift the right foot forward, take the left behind. Here's our lunge. Right palm is down, rotating left arm and fingers overhead. Bringing that left hand down to the mat, rotating right arm and fingers overhead. Right hand down to the mat. And then we'll inhale up, putting that right forearm on top of the right thigh as we take that left arm up overhead. And the only thing we're changing is the position of our arms. Left forearm on top of the right thigh. And taking that right arm up overhead. And then taking that into our reverse warrior. Right hand says hello to the sun. From reverse warrior, we'll take that into our warrior one. Taking that into warrior two, right arm is forward, left is behind. We'll turn our palms upward. Draw those elbows in towards your sides. Stretching out. Elbows in towards our sides. Stretching out, and once more, elbows in towards our side, and stretching out. We'll take that back into our warrior one, connecting our palms together. Thumbs in between our eyebrows as we look up for third eye. Bringing those hands to heart center. Here's our twist. Left elbow, right knee, turning to the side. And we'll put both hands down by the right foot. Scooting that right foot back. Into our down dog. Tucking my chin, bringing that left knee forward and holding. more plank. Shifted left, left hip towards the mat. Coming back into our plank. We're coming all the way down. Your choice, either coming up on your forearms for Sphinx, or palms down and pushing back for Cobra. When you're ready, tucking your toes, down dog. Turning our palms up, bringing those elbows into our sides, stretching out, elbows into our sides, stretching out, elbows into our sides. Stretching out. And finally back into our warrior one. We'll bring both hands down on either side of that left foot. We're getting ready. We're bringing that right foot forward into our forward fold. As we exhale, we're going to bring our chest closer to our thighs. So exhaling, chest closer to our thighs. Inhaling, straightening our back. Exhaling, chest closer to our thighs. Inhaling, straightening our back. One more. Exhaling, bringing our chest inward, closer to our thighs. Inhaling, straightening our back. And slowly rolling up, stretching our arms up overhead. Returning back into our mountain. A breath in and out. Let's take a moment in child's pose. So coming forward into our table and then into our child. Shavasana, out in the light. Your exhalation. Slowly bringing your awareness to your forehead, smoothing out your forehead. Relaxing your eyebrows. Relaxing that place between your eyebrows. Drawing the relaxation down through your cheeks and into your jaw. Maybe opening your mouth just a little bit. Inviting your jaw to relax. Drawing the relaxation down through your neck. And as you exhale, dropping your shoulders, releasing them. Thinking about deepening that space between the bottom of your ears and the tops of your shoulders. Drawing the relaxation down through your arms, into your wrists, softening your hands, releasing your fingers. Allowing your thoughts to just come and go. Bringing that relaxation down through your chest, into your tummy. Relaxing your hips. Softening your thighs, releasing your knees, lower legs, ankles, and your feet. And taking a moment to drift and melt. On today's journey, you find yourself walking along a path, and you're entering a wildlife sanctuary. The path that you walk on is paved, and it's just wide enough for walking. Wild grass grows beside the path. trees here and there along the way. Inhaling the fresh air, exhaling any remaining tension in your body. As you follow the path, you know it curves up ahead. Following that curve, you find that the path goes beside a small pond. As you walk closer to the water, the sun shines down. You feel very content and peaceful. You notice reeds growing in the shallow water at the edge of the pond. And some quacking of ducks catches your attention. And you see the mother duck swimming ahead, and behind her are several ducklings. Noticing the soft downy feathers of the ducklings, and noticing the small wakes that the ducklings leave behind them. Taking a moment in this beautiful place to see what's meant for you to see on your journey today. Coming back to your breath, noticing its peaceful, easy rhythm. Taking a moment to give thanks for whatever comes to mind today. Also taking a moment to think about our intentions. Good things we'd like to do. Gathering those positive affirmations in our mind. And when we have those intentions gathered together, either in our mind's eye, or we can raise our arms up over our head, send all those good thoughts outward. Taking a deep breath in, exhaling out. Reconnecting with our bodies. Noticing the rise and fall of our chest. As we inhale, and as we exhale, checking in with our fingers, wiggling our fingers, seeing how they feel, checking in with our toes, wiggling our toes, noticing how they feel. Allowing our senses to bring us back to the room around us. Any sounds in the room, the temperature of the room. Taking a deep breath in, exhaling out. And when you're ready to come back from your journey, only when you're ready to come back, gently sitting up and taking your time. being here today. And the clock on the wall is a little fast. I have 9:46, so that's a little fast.